What's that sound? Sounds like a timer or something.
Are you sure?
No, I'm not sure. It's in the bag. Can you open the bag, please, and check it?
A bomb!
Did you hear that explosion?
Order a new bag.
Hi, this is Rainer.
And this is Michael.
And we are your camera bags. No, we are from your camera bags. Your German camera bag and rucksack guys. Hi, this is Rainer.
And this is Michael, and we are from yourcamerabags.com.
Yeah, the German camera bag and rucksack guys. And today we review the Kaden messenger bag in color khaki.
Khaki.
Khaki, yeah. In German we say khaki, it's like poop. Poop. Kaden is a Chinese manufacturer. I was searching for a website and it wasn't there, but the company exists. And we tell you more about it later. They have seem to have a great customer service, so don't be worried.
Price point for this camera bag is $30 or 36 euros if you are living in Europe.
You used it for a while,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. I've used it for several weeks and I've tested it by photographing.
Yeah, and we will tell you later what Rainer thinks. We don't tell you now. Okay. The design is, I like it. It doesn't scream camera bag, and which is really nice. So you can use it for?
It nearly for everything. You can put everything in here. It's a vintage style messenger bag made out of canvas.
Yeah. And one thing I noticed is it has no handle. It's missing. So you didn't remove it, right?
No, I didn't remove it, but you're right, the handle is missing.
The overall quality seems pretty good. The stitching is solid, and sometimes it's even with a double stitched seam, as you can see here, which provides a stronger seam, and we like it. And we will see now if it stands Rainer's
heavy pull test.
So stay tuned in a few seconds.
Pull, Rainer, pull, pull stronger. Pull, 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 and stop.
Okay, Rainer is really strong, but nothing is torn. Looks fine. A pad is missing, right?
Yeah, it has no shoulder pad. And it's if you use it for a few hours, heavy equipped, then it's getting uncomfortable.
Okay. But it's how long? If you use it like with medium equipment for like 2 or 3 hours, it works?
It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
Okay. But don't forget, if you're using only a shirt, if you're wearing only a shirt, then it's getting more uncomfortable.
Okay. Good. Then on the bottom, we have the tripod holders. And these are plastic buckles, which I think is nice. When you watch our review from the Amazon bag, it's much more difficult with the other bags to open these. That's easy. And they can be expanded here. Yeah, that's good. You can put a quite large tripod in there, but there's one disadvantage. You have to attach your tripod to the bottom. That means you need to be careful when you put it down or move it.
There are two side pockets with quick snap on it, yeah, to close it.
It's easy access, but they're not very useful, I think, because Rainer, they're open here. Yeah.
They're
so
open.
I would only put in tissues or anything which is not camera gear. Okay. And I mean, at least you have two, each on one side.
the fasteners. It's a mixed material here. It's also a leather substitute. And the buckles here are made out of metal.
Exactly, that's good. And it's good, I like that quick access here with that snap. It's, you don't have to open the buckle here.
Yep.
You can use that quick access. Front pocket?
Front pocket is very big. It also feels a little wishy-washy, but it's very big. A lot of stuff will fit in there.
And this will be interesting later when we do our extreme weather tests, if the stuff you put in there gets wet. The main compartment. This is interesting because, as you can see, this is an insert. And this is not actually, this is a standard messenger bag with an insert for camera gear. You got this one with two large dividers and nothing else. And you can see it's, yeah, we will see it later when we put stuff in there. It's, yeah, there's a lot of space here. And the last pocket?
You got an inside pocket on the back for smaller stuff like a smartphone, for example, or a small wallet.
Great, okay. Now, let's put stuff in there. Okay, Rainer put everything in there. He's the packing master. And now let's open it and see if we're happy with the space it provides.
Well, I put in a Panasonic FZ1000, a large bridge camera.
DSLR size, right?
DSLR size. And a medium E-mount 18 to 135 telephoto lens. And a bigger telephoto lens, it's the 100-300 Panasonic MFT lens.
And what I noticed is when you put stuff in there, like this lens, and it's okay, but you can't put anything else in there. It's, the pocket is just deep, but not spacious enough otherwise. Because, I mean, would you put, no, two lenses?
No,
it's too dangerous. It's too dangerous.
Lens,
I mean,
yeah.
It would be great if there would be more dividers, because maybe you could put in a divider there and something smaller there. But that way, you can not put enough things, gear in there.
Actually, the bag looks bigger from the size than it really is.
Exactly. And the insert, here's enough space around the insert. It's like empty space. It's not very useful. I mean, the insert should be bigger. Okay.
Exactly.
Next pocket, the front pocket.
The front pocket, I put in my wallet.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that because
filter.
It's too dangerous, right? in the front.
Yeah.
But the front pocket is nice. It's spacious and you can put a lot of stuff in there.
Yeah.
And the final pocket, the inside pocket or pouch. Here it's pretty safe. So Rainer put in his phone, which is okay. Yeah.
1 minute paddle test.
I think it got wet.
I don't know exactly. Inside it's not wet. Take a look.
Okay.
It's completely dry and also the paper is dry.
And when checking the bottom of the bag from the outside, it seems as if it's sort of water repellent, but we're not sure. We check everything later in half an hour again if anything got wet. But first, Rainer is performing our
heavy rain test.
I'm really excited.
Yeah, but it seems.
Okay, how's
inside
the inside
here?
Is it dry?
Is it dry?
Really? Okay.
Yeah, it's dry. Yeah.
Again, we're always surprised, guys.
The outside is wet completely, but the inside is dry, and it seems it's water repellent or water resistant. Okay, now look. So some, it soaked through the zipper. Okay?
Ah,
you see
okay.
It here?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
here? There's a little. So it's a little wet on the bottom of the inside.
Yeah, it is.
It is? Okay. So now we have a look to the main compartment.
This is wet now. This is really wet.
Okay.
Look at this. Okay, so.
Which was not the case after our paddle test.
Exactly, but.
But half an hour later.
The bottom is soaked. Yeah. Okay, that's not good. So.
But from the heavy rain test from the outside here.
Yeah, that's
from
not,
the top.
That's not too bad. Yeah.
It's okay.
So it's the stuff which is wet is at the bottom. So the heavy rain test was quite okay, but from the paddle test, look at this, it's extremely wet. The front pocket. It's okay. I don't think it's dry. This is interesting.
Yeah, it's dry. Yeah. And also the bottom of the front pocket. It's dry.
Okay.
Okay. Good result for the front pocket.
We don't check the side pockets because I wouldn't, Jackie, I wouldn't put anything in there during when you know it's raining anyway. So, great result for the front. Well, good result for the front pocket. Bad result for the bottom. We thought the insert is sort of water resistant, but it seems like, oh, look at this. Look at this. It got really wet.
All right, now the summary. Rainer, the cons first, please.
The missing handle makes it inconvenient for daily use. The bag looks big, but the actual space for the camera gear is limited. Especially the bottom gets soaked on wet grounds. The shoulder strap has no pad, which makes wearing the bag uncomfortable after a while.
Okay, the pros. The design is a nice vintage style which doesn't scream camera bag. With the insert removed, it can also be used as a casual bag. The material seems sturdy and durable enough. The bag is cheap, but offers a good value for the price.
Okay, Rainer, who should buy this bag?
Well, this bag is for people for which styling is important, for example, and who do not need to carry their complete stuff, their complete equipment within this bag, because there's limited space on the inside.
I just wanted to say, we already showed you before, the limited space, it's not really the manufacturer's fault, because with that design, it's not possible to put in a larger insert. We tried it and it looks like this insert is not big, but it just fits in the bag.
And don't forget, you can use it for as a travel bag. If you put the insert out and use it only as a travel bag, a stylish travel bag, and you can use it as a camera bag.
Exactly, you can remove the insert, use it for ever what you like. And again, regarding the design, I mean, some people might say, yeah, the design, it's not that important. It is important. I think we both think, right? It's important because, I mean, you carry this bag like clothing and it should look good. This is the thing. When you buy a cheap, relatively cheap camera bag under 50 bucks, you can choose from great design and decent features like this one. Or if you need more sturdiness, if you need more waterproof on the top, you saw those little stains, it's not 100% water repellent, then buy the Amazon Basics. We made a review for this one, and it, of course, it doesn't look good, right? I mean, the design is really non-existent.
Yeah, in our opinion, this bag looks much better than the Amazon Basic.
Yeah,
bag.
Exactly.
Okay, for
it,
sure.
It looks much better. And one thing we like is the manufacturer seems to have a really good service. So if you write them, they answer you back. And from other reviews, we saw that camera bags got replaced by the manufacturer without any questions. So yeah, company seems good. And you got a great design, you got other things, but like I love the quick snaps here. Okay, it's limited space, but well,
So tell us, what's your opinion? Do you prefer design over functionality or functionality over design? Please write it down in the comments.
Yeah, and give us a thumbs up or down.
And subscribe to our channel.
You always say don't give a thumbs down.
Yeah, really.
But you can do whatever you want. Subscribe to our channel, and if you check out our other review or reviews, it depends on when you're watching this, how many are online.
There are more to come.
Yes, and there's one must-watch video already online. We put a link in the description below. The three best camera bags under $50. There, we compare this Kaden bag with two other great bags. Okay, more reviews? There are definitely more to come, and with extreme testing. And write if you have any idea, or if you want us to test a special bag, write it in the comments. We try to organize it. Okay.
I can't stand this any longer. Bank robbery. Always on the run. Explosions. Why me? Why always me?
Quit whining.